Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today in this video, I'm going to be talking about my service dogs, Caspian and Clark. Caspian here is 80 pounds and then Clark here is about 25 pounds. So I'm going to be going over the differences between having a small service dog versus a large service dog. Now be sure to subscribe to my channel to see more videos about service dogs. Now before I start off the video, I do want to give a shout out to Amore Handmade. They make beautiful collars for dogs, and if you buy a collar from them, you are supporting indigenous artists that are also women down in Mexico. So I love their collars, I love supporting them, and here is the discount code for that. One other quick announcement that I want to make is that I am selling t-shirts and hoodies over on Teespring, where 100% of the profit goes directly to wildlife warriors who are helping out the animals that have been affected by the wildfires in Australia. Please check that out and please consider buying a t-shirt so that we can help some of the animals down there. Also, be sure to go follow Clark over on Instagram because he does have his own Instagram page where you get to see his service dog adventures. So a brief summary of my service dogs for anybody that is new here is that I have several different types of anxiety disorders, and in order to manage those anxiety disorders, I use my service dogs to help me out with that. So first is Caspian here, and he's the big one. He is was my first service dog, and he worked for about 7 years, and he's gonna be 9 in March, so that's older for a big dog. He's senior now. And then Clark here is 3 years old, and he is my current service dog that is working right now. Caspian's retired for the most part, and Caspian was trained by an agency, so basically he was trained with a professional trainer since he was a puppy, and then I got him later. And then Clark, I actually trained myself, so he's a dog that I purchased as a puppy and put him through the training myself. So that's kind of the differences between the two. But yeah, I've had a service dog for a long time now. So Caspian is mostly retired. I say mostly because I do take him out once in a while instead of Clark, or like Clark got a face injury recently, and so I was actually working Caspian instead of Clark. But Clark's really the one that I am using for the most part now, and Caspian is really going into retirement. And so I've been getting asked to do this video for a while now, and I'm kind of glad I didn't do it right away, that I kind of put it off, because that's given me more time to spend with Clark to be able to really see what differences there are. And then too, when Clark was sick and I was taking Caspian out, then those differences were immediate. So at first, I feel like it wasn't as noticeable when I was mostly using Clark, but then once I used, you know, Caspian one day, all of a sudden I saw the differences more clearly. So hopefully that will make this video more informative. So immediately the biggest differences between the two is obviously size. There's a big difference in that. And of course too, the fact that Caspian is not only a psychiatric service dog, but he was also trained for mobility support. And Clark, of course, cannot be used for mobility support because he's so small. And when I was using Caspian, I did use him as a mobility support service dog as well. I have nerve pain in my back that doesn't hurt my back, but it hurts my legs, if that makes sense. And once I was able to actually figure out where my leg pain was coming from, I've been able to manage that a lot better, and I haven't needed to use that mobility support. So having Clark just as a psychiatric service dog has been totally fine. And that was something that I always was saying and telling doctors, is that there was nothing wrong with my legs. And so it's really satisfying to actually be right about that. So that's something that's really been improving for me now that I have more of a diagnosis on that. Now, I know one thing that people get really confused by is psychiatric service dog versus emotional support dog. Those are two completely different things. These are not emotional support dogs. These are service dogs because they are trained to actually help me. And I don't really want to get into it more than that because I've done so many videos trying to explain the difference, and I don't want this video to end up being about that. But if you don't understand why these aren't emotional support dogs, please go check out my other videos. So let's talk about the differences between having a big psychiatric service dog versus a small one. Now, I actually prefer Clark's size. And I was kind of worried about it at first because I thought that there would be a lot of things that Clark couldn't do that Caspian could do. But in regards to the task work, no, actually Clark is being able to do all the stuff that Caspian can do. Blocking, for example, Clark is long, so he can actually do blocking between people, like when I'm standing somewhere. For example, when you're in a grocery store line and people have no concept of personal space, and it can give you, well, somebody like me, it can give me worse anxiety if somebody's standing really close to me. I don't like people touching my back or things like that, and so I can position Clark behind me so that he gives me that space. So that's one thing that he does. He can also be positioned in front of me as well. When it does come to crowd control, I do think that Caspian does a little bit better of a job. Find a door, that's something that's much easier for Caspian, like pulling through a crowd, whereas I have to be a little bit more careful with Clark. And then when it comes to blocking, one difference between them is that I do feel like Caspian starts blocking immediately when we're around people, whereas Clark waits for a command. And that might just be because Caspian's been working longer than Clark, so. And then there's deep pressure therapy. And to me, I think this is one of the most important tasks that a psychiatric service dog does. And that's actually what Clark is doing right now. So deep pressure therapy is kind of like a weighted blanket where it helps you feel grounded. It's warm, it's heavy, and that can really help relieve anxiety. And so I actually really prefer Clark for this. Clark, I feel, is a perfect size. He will lay on my back, he'll lay on the front of my chest, he'll lay in my lap. It just really depends on where I'm at and what's comfortable to me. Caspian did this more like with his head, because he's a really big dog and he can do this like with body weight. But I'm a small person, and so I just felt like Caspian's weight was too much, and then he did it with his head and it's just not the same. So I prefer Clark's body weight for this. Then there's waking me up from nightmares, and this is something that Clark is really good at. Caspian does not like sleeping with me, and so that's one of the things that was a little hard for him, is that he didn't like being on the bed, and Clark loves sleeping with me, so that's worked out a lot better. Clark is really, really good at helping me sleep through the night. Tactile stimulation or pressure therapy is kind of like deep pressure therapy in the sense that it really does like the same thing, but in a much different sense. So with deep pressure therapy, it's like this, it's a constant pressure. With tactile stimulation, you're getting the dog to constantly like nudge, lick, push, just back and forth movement, more of like a playful stimulation. This interrupts anxiety, and this is just something that's really helpful to get your mind off of whatever is giving you that anxiety. So for tactile stimulation, I think I actually prefer Caspian. Both dogs are really good about this, but Caspian is just way more intense about it. And that's probably also a size thing. So Clark is more subtle about it, and probably just because he's smaller and Caspian's bigger. And then Clark's legs are so short, so he can't really use them. But then two, Clark won't bite me and Caspian will. I'm not talking about something like aggressive, but in tactile stimulation, like the dog using its mouth and being rougher when it has to is really good. And Caspian is very pushy about it. He really will get my attention no matter how hard he has to work for it. And Clark is a lot more subtle. He's gentle, nudges, licks, and doesn't like to use his mouth on me. And that's something I've tried to get him to do a little bit more, but he's just really gentle and it's not something he seems to like doing. So yeah, that's something different there between that task and these two dogs. Now, when it comes to anxiety alert or panic alert, both of these dogs are amazing at that. They're really good. This was the thing that I was the most worried about training, because honestly, I had no idea what I was doing when it came to that. With this, when you're gonna go into a panic attack or your anxiety is really elevating, your body is creating a certain hormone and releases a smell that the dogs can detect. And I think this is called cortisol. And so when they smell that, they're able to tell you and alert you. And oftentimes you haven't noticed that your anxiety level is really increasing as quickly as the dogs will. So like you won't be aware that a situation is really stressing you out, and then the dog tells you, and this prevents panic attacks. This helps relieve anxiety because they know to do task work without being told when this happens, or just letting you know that you are really having bad anxiety. So this is something that I was really nervous about training. And Caspian was trained by a professional. He trained him for that. And so I didn't know how to apply that to Clark. And actually what I did was, when I was asking Clark for certain task work because I felt anxious, he started noticing when that was gonna happen. And before you knew it, Clark was actually alerting me to my anxiety because he knew, like, I guess he smelled it, you know, and then he was like, oh, I'm gonna be asked to do this, and started doing it anyway. So that was really cool. Just really impressed with how smart he was in being able to figure that out. And it's like, I'm like, oh, I trained him for anxiety alert. And really, I'm like, it was just, I guess, a happy coincidence. Now, the biggest difference when it comes to public access is, this one's really odd to me, is that I have never, well, as of yet, had my access rights questioned with Clark. And this was something I fought with constantly with Caspian. And obviously I've had Caspian for more years, so there's more instances where it could have come up. But I've been working with Clark for a long time now, and it hasn't happened once. And that's something that's really surprising to me. Personally, I feel like Caspian looks way more official than Clark does, but I guess it's just size and how people see it, and people see Caspian is more of a threat and Clark not so much, so they don't really care, I guess. But yeah, that's been something that's been surprising to me. And that is one thing, like, Caspian is more threatening in the way that he looks. He's a big dog. He's just, I guess people are more scared of him, and then people aren't of Clark. And since I've been a lot more involved in politics, that is one of the beneficial things from Clark, is that Clark's a much, you know, friendlier looking dog and all of that. So that's been helpful in that aspect. And then of course you do have your dog lovers who don't think that any dog looks threatening or anything like that. And so it has been a lot easier to deal with that, I feel, with Clark than with Caspian. I'm not sure there's anything more annoying than somebody trying to just sneak in a pet or grab the dog as they walk by. It's because people are just so entitled. And that was something that happened a lot with Caspian, but Clark is so short that people can't do that. And if people do try to go for Clark, it's very obvious because he's so short, so they really have to reach. And by that point, you can move the dog or step in front or something. And with Caspian, he was just there, and he's very much like at like where your hand is, where you can just drive by pet. So that's one of the things I really, really like about having such a short service dog, is that you avoid a lot of that. And that's just one of the difficult things of that you have to deal with when you're out in public with a service dog. Now, like I said before, I am a lot more involved in politics, and so having a friendlier dog has been beneficial in that aspect. And that's where Caspian and Clark are really different, because Caspian does not like strangers, he doesn't like people, and he's the type of service dog that does not want to be pet. And when somebody would drive by pet him or try to grab him, it would really upset him. You know, it'd throw him off his game, and he'd just be, I could tell he was annoyed in that situation. And with Caspian, I mean, like, rightfully so. If I was Caspian, I would have bitten a lot of people. With Clark, he's different, and he doesn't mind that so much. When he has been pet, where it's like unexpected, he handles it really well. And then he is able to greet people and do, like, you know, little pets and stuff, and then go back to working immediately. And that was something Caspian just wasn't good with, is I felt like once that happened with him, we had to take a few minutes to really get him back to where he was. And it's not like he got out of control or something. It's more just, honestly, I was probably the only person that even noticed. But when you know your dog, you know how they're feeling. And Caspian did not like having to deal with other people that wanted to touch him and pet him. And so Clark's a lot better about that. Now, when it comes to seeing other service dogs, Clark is a lot better about that than Caspian, and I think this is solely based on experience and has nothing to do with really training or even personality. And I think that's because of all the years I was with Caspian, almost every service dog we ran into, service dog, was a fake service dog and actually tried to attack either me or Caspian. And so when Caspian sees another service dog, he's really alert and watching them because of the bad experiences we've been through. Whereas Clark, we've had a lot less bad experiences, and most of the service dogs that we come across, since I'm doing a lot of stuff like in politics, is veteran service dogs, and they're really well trained, and so he's had a lot of good positive experiences there. The first time he saw another service dog, he actually barked, and it was so embarrassing, and he was still in training, so I corrected that really quick. We got back on track, and that was the only time that that happened, so he's really good about it now. Doesn't really like to greet the dogs, though. Somebody wanted to see if their dog could see Clark, and I was like, okay, but that was not something he liked. He's fine with them, you know, being there, but he still wants a little bit of distance. He doesn't want them sniffing him. Right, there has been one service dog, that did try to attack Clark. It's actually an ESA, and that's like, that could be a whole video in itself, but it tried to attack Clark, and I think Clark was more just like, kind of startled by the situation. It didn't really faze him too much, but yeah, so that's kind of been the differences. Now, one of the other big differences between them is, and this one's kind of a big deal to me, but probably not a big deal to other people, is the amount of gear that they wear. And my service dogs do not wear a lot of gear compared to most people's service dogs, I think. And in this situation, you're probably thinking that Caspian wears more gear, but no, actually it's Clark. With Caspian, he wears just a light vest and a leash that's attached to that vest. And I think the general public sees a leash as something that prevents your dog from running away from you, which it's not. And if you should probably not be taking your dog to a park or somewhere like that if the dog might run away from you. A leash is a communication device, and so they shouldn't be pulling at the end of it. It's not to hold the dog to you, it's a communication thing. And so with Caspian, it was just attached to his vest. Now with Clark, I tried to train him in that way, but when his leash was attached to his vest, we were so out of sync. We're just not being able to communicate with each other. It was bad. And so I use a collar for Clark, and the leash is attached to the collar, and he just wears a light vest. So it's not a huge difference, but to me, I just that was something to get adjusted to. Caspian never wore a collar when he was working, and that's just something, you know, that worked for us. Whereas I moved to this dog, and that did not work. So I think it's just, you know, based on the dog. So that was an interesting one to me. Now, when it comes to endurance, I think Caspian is better about that. I think he has more endurance than Clark, but Clark has been building up his endurance. And that's one thing, like, both of these dogs are super lazy. They're just very, very lazy dogs. That's something I feel most people miss when they're trying to pick out their own service dog or get their own service dog, is that they don't understand that you want a dog that is really laid back and really relaxed, and they want to pick out this dog that's like super energetic and like running up to greet you. And it's like when you go and pick out a puppy from a litter, and there's the one that comes like running up to greet you, and that's what people usually want to pick. And those are great dogs, but really you want the puppy in the back that's just like hanging out. And that's like what Clark was. He had two brothers that were like pushing each other out of the way to go and greet people, and Clark was just kind of sitting in the back, like just really chill. And that's a really important thing for a service dog, and that's what makes him so great going out into public and everything and being able to see all kinds of different situations and not overreact to them. So it's really important to have a really chill dog. Now, one of the major differences between these two dogs is the amount of care that they require. And like, Caspian handles the elements much better than Clark. So with Caspian, I used shoes for him only when I had to. He really hated them. Most of the time we did not have shoes. And then he never had a coat. He actually loves winter. And he handled winter better than summer, but he still, he did pretty well during summer too. But never had a coat or anything like that. He didn't like to eat while he was working. So I try to make sure he had water, but he never wanted to have any food. He could hold going to the bathroom for like ever. I hardly had to be taken out as well. As far as keeping him clean, I got Caspian groomed like once a month, and I sent him off to the groomers and they did like the bath and brush and everything. And so I did some brushes in between that, but he was super easy to keep clean. I feel like Caspian was just like super self-sufficient. Now with Clark, it's like the exact opposite, and that has been one of the biggest adjustments of going from Caspian to Clark, is just the amount of care and attention that Clark needs compared to that. So like, for example, he wears shoes almost all summer, and that's at least one thing is that he wears the shoes. He tolerates the shoes a lot better than Caspian, so shoes aren't difficult with him, but he does have to have them like all summer. He gets very cold, and so during winter he has to always have like his sweater and stuff, so I have to bring that and put that on him. And then when it comes to like food, he requires food more often. He requires food and water more often than Caspian. And you can tell when Clark's hungry too, because I say his brain is actually in his tummy. So he gets fed more often. Then he also needs to go to the bathroom more often, and so Clark will definitely let me know when he needs to go pee outside. So that's more often. And when it comes to keeping him clean, Clark gets dirty. Like, he gets dirty often. I have to give him a bath like all the time, and so he gets a bath about twice a week usually. And that's pretty often. Like, I would recommend not washing a dog more than once a week. It's actually vet recommended for Clark to get a bath twice a week, because it helps out his skin a lot, because he has allergies and things like that. So yeah, that's often, and I wouldn't recommend it for everybody. But at least Clark is easy to groom, and that is like one thing too, that's I can get him like bathed and dried and everything in under like half an hour. So at least there's that, since I do have to bathe him so often. And I bathe Clark myself. I don't send him to the groomers, because he throws up like every time he goes to the groomers. So he just stays at home. And then Caspian is so, so serious when he's working. And this thing is like a robot. Whereas Clark is a lot more like happy-go-lucky, sometimes kind of goofy. So it's been really interesting seeing the big difference in their personalities, but the fact that both service dogs do such a good job and really focus on being service dogs, on doing their task work. If you guys do have any questions about my service dogs, please leave them down below in the comments. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I hope you got to enjoy seeing the differences between the two. And I'll see you next time. Bye!